Hello friends, this is Dipika Gautam and welcomes you in our YouTube channel InterviewCon, and thank you for joining InterviewCon. So in this video, I am going to discuss about classes and methods in C#. Okay, so now let's get started. Before going to start this session, if you till now did not subscribe my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and don't forget to hit that bell icon. Okay, so when I will upload a new video, you will get notification for new video. Okay, so now let's get started. If you haven't watched my previous video of this series, then please watch my previous video so you understand what is the topic we are going to cover in this series. Okay, so this is the first video of my use concept. So what is class in C# program? A class is a construct that enables you to create your own custom tags by grouping together variables of other tags. Okay, method and events. A class is like a blueprint. It defines the data and behavior of a tag. So it is just like a blueprint. It does not have any space. It does not contain any space. It is just like a blueprint. Okay, so this is the simple syntax to create a class, modify class and class name, and here class body. Okay, so if the class is not declared as static, client code can use it by creating object or instance which are assigned to a variable. So I will discuss all these things, how to create an instance and how to create object of the class. Okay, so the variable remains in memory until all reference to it go out of scope. At that time, the CLR marks it as eligible for garbage collection. So I already have made video on CLR. So if you haven't watched that video, then please watch my video on CLR. What is CLR and .NET? Okay. So if the class is declared as static, so there are so many types of classes. So here I am going to talk about static class. So if the class is declared as static, then only one copy exists in the memory and client code can only access it through the class itself. But here, if a class is static, then at that time we cannot access that class by using the instance. Okay, so itself not an instance variable, so we can access by only calling the itself. Okay, but not by creating the instance variable. Okay, some key points about classes. So classes are reference type that holds the object created dynamically in a heap memory. Okay, the default access modifiers of class, the default access modifiers of method and variable is private. Okay, so all classes have a base type of system.object. All the classes base type is system.object. Okay, the default access modifier of a class is internal. By default it is internal. For the method and variables, that is private. Okay, this is also the most important interview question. They are sometimes asked what is the default access modifier for class, what is the default modifier for method and variables. Okay, so don't forget to take for method and variables, the default access modifier is private. For a class, that is internal. So the next point is, directly inside the namespace, declaring of private classes are not allowed. So what is method? So method is nothing but, a method is a code block that contains a series of statements. Okay, a program causes the statements to be executed by calling the method and specifying any required method arguments. In C#, every executed instruction is performed in the context of a method. The main method is the entry point of every C# application, and it is called by the common language runtime CLR when the program is started. Okay, the syntax of creating the method here: math modifiers, void and type, name, method name, parameters. Okay, we can define here parameters. and here method body or we can say statements. Okay. So now let's get understand with the help of example so you can understand better. So here I have opened my Visual Studio 2017. Here I have a folder. Oops, there is no class. So I am going to add a new class here. Add and class. Okay. So I am giving you a name of the class. Suppose my class is first. Okay. Or we can say it is a test class. Test class. Okay. So I have created a class inside the Oops folder. So I am going to talk about the class here and method and how to create an object and how to create an instance. Okay. So this video is all about how to create a class, how to create a variable, how to create a method and how to create an instance and object. All the things I am going to cover. So please be careful. Okay. Because this video is very important for you. Okay, here because I am going to start my Oops concept, so it is very useful. So this is the class. Here we can create a modifiers and we can say here, suppose I am giving you public. Okay, so here public, but it is according to the requirement. So I am not giving anything here. In that, I am going to create a method. Okay, so method. What is method? Method, I already have discussed. A method is an action that has to be performed, and once after performing an action, it may or may not return a value. Once again, a method is an action that has to be performed, and once after performing an action, it may or may not return a value. So, method are two types, value returning method and non-value returning method. So I am going to create a method here. So before creating a method, I want to talk about the modifiers. What is modifiers? Modifiers are the special keyword that we use on a method optionally. Okay. So there are so many modifiers: public, private, internal, protected, virtual, abstract, override, field, partial, static. Okay. So what is void and type? Remember the previous, I have shown you the syntax of method creation. So there, what is void or type? So void or type under a method is to specify whether the method is value returning method or non-value returning method. Okay. Void specifies that the method is non-value returning method. Suppose if I am going to create a method by using void keyword, that means we can say the method is non-value returning method. Okay. So, whereas if a type is specified, it is, suppose if I will type declare by int or a string. So that means we can say method is value returning. Okay. The return type of the method need not be a predefined type like suppose int float. So that cannot be like that. Integer, float, character, boolean, like that. Okay. It can also be user defined also. Okay. You can also define a user defined. So now suppose I am going to create a method. So void. Void, suppose my method name is test. Okay. Or we can say demo. So demo. Demo is my method. Okay. In this method, I am going to write some statement. Suppose demo method. Okay. So this is my simple method and it does not have any modifier and also it does not have any parameters. Okay. Suppose if I will create a method by using a modifier. Okay. Or without modifier, or we can say with some, I am going to create a method with some parameters. Oh, okay. So now let's understand. So suppose I am also going to use here some, modifiers. Okay, so I am going to here use public modifiers. So public void or we can say demo1. Okay. So demo 2 here, so create demo 1. Okay, suppose I am going to declare some parameters also here. Suppose integer, integer as parameter and a. Okay, so now I am going to return, I want to print that value in this. So console.write line, I am going to print the value of a. A value I want to print here. Okay, now, so this is all about the method creation, and I have not talked about here about the method, so I am just putting the demonstration. Okay, so now I am going to create the method, main method here. So static void main. Okay, don't forget here main, N is capital. Okay friends, so after that, now I want to create the object of this class. So what is the difference between object and instance? Okay, so now understand, suppose my class is test class, and if I will create a variable here, so what it is variable. Okay friends, now test, suppose here v, or we can say obj, is equal to new test. So now my object is created. Okay, it can be anything. I have taken here obj. Okay, so without new keyword we cannot create the object of the class. So which class we have created the object? Test class object is created by name the object and is obj. Okay friends, so how do I call this method? By using the object name of the class. Okay, so obj dot, I have two methods here, but here equals get hashcode, get tab, member wise clone, and twisting also there are so many. So I am going to call this method demo one. Okay friends, so now I am going to create another method, that is my we can say demo 2. Okay, for that method I have to pass some value here, because it will ask, you can see here, now it is asking int a, so it is asking integer value you have to give. So suppose I am giving here 15, so error is gone. Now console.readline, so before going to run this program, this class, I want to tell you something. So I have created here variable, it is the variable. Okay, it is the object obj. So creation of the object by using the new keyword. So what is this? This is nothing but it is a constructor. So what is constructor? Constructor is actually, we will talk about the later in this series. Constructor is a big topic and it is also very important concept. Okay, so this is also the class name, you can see here. So what is the difference between constructor and class? Okay, so I will talk these all the things in the later video, but here I am going to just tell you the difference is here. You can see here it is the you can see here parenthesis. Okay, parenthesis here, this bracket is showing you, that means it is a method. Okay, this bracket is showing you it is a method. So we can say here this is called constructor, and without this bracket it is called class. Okay, it is very similar, but don't forget, okay, it is the constructor and it is the class. Okay, so now I am going to run this class, and first, before going to run this class, first we need to set the file. So oops, set class. Okay friends, so this is, my program is done here, my test class. So what is content? Class, what class contains? Class contains field. and property, method and event. We can also create here integer a. Okay, so what is this? It is nothing but field. Okay, variable, we can say variable. Okay, event, properties and method, we can create multiple things in the class. Okay, so what is class? Class is nothing but it is a blueprint. It does not contain any memory space. Okay, so by using the class object, we can access that method and all the things we can access by using the creating the class object. Okay, now I am going to run this program so you can understand better. See, it will print first demo method and after that it will print 50. Okay, so now run, press F5 or directly start. You can see the output. Output should be expected, demo method and 50. Okay friends, so now let's, it will take some time because it is, I'm going to run first and okay, build succeeded. After that it will going to show you the rails of our this program, or we can say it is a class, so it will show the rails. Okay, so rails should be expected, demo method and just wait for a moment. Okay, so here demo method and 50. So this is all about the class and methods, and I will talk about all the things in the later video. So don't forget to watch my next video. Thank you guys and all the best. Keep watching, keep learning. This is my Facebook page, you can follow me on my Facebook page, and this is my blog, but the most important questions are available here. And before going to discuss and before going to end of this video, first of all I want to say something. There's so many playlist here, C# interview program. Okay, this is a very important and OOPS concept, and here SQL Server interview question and ASP.NET interview question. These all are the playlist are very important for you guys. If you are fresh and looking for the job, don't miss to watch these playlist. All the videos are very important, so don't miss this video. Okay guys, thank you and all the best.